Hello friends, this is Global Patriot John Adams here. We're looking at my Instagram. We've been busy harvesting some American beauty berries out there. Those are absolutely delicious. I highly suggest you try to find some. You could actually find some stuff frozen on branches and stuff at this point. Yeah, but besides that, we really wanted to discuss Thomas Brinkley. So this seems to be incredibly sketch. I think that he is actually related to several different incidents. And the reason is that these people, apparently, he's also claimed, or people that had been talking with him and following him on his YouTube before he was likely offed, but they had claimed that he thought that he was involved with the Aurora thing, or that the Aurora thing was actually pretty much set up to get him. And this is 100% totally possible. I can guarantee you that this is possible if they were going to try to make guns look bad and whatnot. If they're going to try and do that, they may as well try to go for, you know, a movie theater with where they know someone that they want is in there. I mean, why try to get 30 innocent people when they could probably get 29 innocent people and one guy that they really want? That's a lot more valuable than 30 totally innocent people. So if they had a target there, that's totally possible. Who knows if this Aurora shooter is legitimate? He apparently thinks that he was MK-Ultra'd and drugged himself. So it's very possible. What if this guy was a conspiracy theorist? Thomas Brinkley was a conspiracy theorist. They try to clash these two conspiracy theorists together. And now at this point, both of these people are considered conspiracy theorists, crazy people. Or at least Thomas Brinkley is considered a conspiracy theorist, crazy person. This guy is just considered crazy. Here we can see, though, look at his hair. Please look at this guy's hair. It's all oranged out, but it's like ultra orangey. It actually looks almost exactly like this guy Thomas Brinkley's hair. So that's very sketchy. Here we see Thomas Brinkley's haircut. It's similar in a way. We've also seen the increase in these red clown things. Alex Jones has started talking about clowns with red hair. So it's possible that Thomas Brinkley could have been hit by this clown psyop after they killed him, or right during, or something like that. They probably would start it right during the off him, and then, you know, they've been mentally programmed against registering his face and whatnot. Look at his hair right here, you see. And I'm about to play you some of this video. He seems to be, under my observation, I believe this guy was a 100% legit individualism supporter. Someone who supports freedom and liberty, who was taken out by basically the media. The media runs basically the black ops and the media itself, and they're totally directly tied to the police. They can get the police, or at least one police officer, to say pretty much whatever they want on the media as some type of evidence. They can buy out anybody and everybody. They have control of the dollar to be able to do this. So they're paying off everybody, all the mainstream media, any way they want, and they can easily tie this guy to some shooting. If he says that he's involved in the shooting, I personally believe it's 100%. Not that he was involved. They could have, who knows, if they were going in there, they were going to shoot a bunch of people and say he did it, and then he possibly escaped, or maybe they were going to try to kill him with the people and he escaped as well. He was more likely ready for some type of crazy shit to happen, and so when it happens, he's just more than likely just going to get out there and run away, or possibly just observe. Honestly, he probably just ran away. If he was an actual videographer person, and he didn't want to just run, he would have actually videoed. So I'm not 100% sure about everything. Even if he's some type of setup to where he's being funded, I mean, that's sketch in itself. So if he's not a legitimate individual liberty supporter and he's being funded, that's very sketch. So, you know, they could be doing that, likely are doing that with people like Alex Jones and Glenn Beck for sure. Glenn Beck and Alex Jones have definitely been, at a very minimum, they've been totally overrun with trolls and whatnot, to the point where if they say something legitimate, I mean, they basically could off more of Alex Jones' family. I mean, he's already having some of his family offed. That's incredibly sketch. And also, we know that the average sheeple just really doesn't register with Alex Jones, so who knows who they're going to kill off next, but it seems they're basically starting the social media genocide. They've started with Thomas Brinkley, and Michael Hastings was basically part of this because he was running Rolling Stone, or was involved with the Rolling Stone magazine. They could have and had the ability to print something against the establishment that would be red. That's what it's simply about. Is it going to be red? Maybe not, because this guy Thomas Brinkley's pumping out these videos, and when he's finally being off, he's only getting, what, 100 views and stuff like that. So they're doing this to all types of people, very likely. Who knows if the Myra May itself thing, we got the Myra May, that could be possibly tied to the Thomas Brinkley incident, or most likely murder, because that happened at Florida State University. This other guy was involved with University of Florida. So they may pick one that's just a little bit different. I mean, it's got almost the exact same name, but reversed. So that's likely, very possibly used to cover up whatever happened with Thomas Brinkley, and he was at University of Florida. And then we just saw a shooting at Florida State University. Also, we see the, like I said, the Aurora shooter has hair identical to that guy's hair. I mean, this is sketch, y'all. I'm telling you right now, this is a real conspiracy theory. Similar to the one how, I mean, Patriot John Adams has basically been tracked possibly his entire life, certainly since the age of 13. Falsely called a terrorist at age 13. I'm getting an argument with this guy. Free Radio Revolution, or some guy. Let me get this in 1 second. Here you can see I'm arguing with this guy, Santiago Green, on the Free Radio Revolution discussion channel. He's like basically arguing with me. He's saying that me being falsely accused of terrorizing cats at the age of 13 because of my name being historically related to patriots and whatnot. Yes, I have historical family heritage. So I ask him, so you don't think children being falsely called terrorists because they have patriotic names has anything to do with the truth community? Laugh out loud, no I don't, not at all. What does that have to do with the truth movement? What does spreading the truth about children being falsely called terrorists because they have patriotic names have anything to do with the truth community? I mean, this is like the dumbest, most idiotic question this guy could possibly ask. That's what I'm concerned with, that it has nothing to do with the truth movement. And then he starts using truth movement only in quotes. I actually used the phrase truth community, and then he starts using the phrase truth movement. So they like to think of things, I guess, as movements, not as communities. Like it's going to be temporary or something. It's absolutely crazy. Yes, I do believe that I'm related to the Patriot John Adams back in the day. It's incredibly likely. I am willing to debate any person about anything, anywhere. So, Patriot John Adams, Ryan, you ought to make some waves. Anson Nummies, signing off.
There is power in the individual, right? So, it's like the individual is kind of where the buck stops, you know? It's all about the rights of the individual, you know, the good of the individual. You owe your moral, you know, like you're morally indebted in a way to an individual, not to some sort of conglomerate entity. I don't know if I'm making sense, but anyway, what I'm trying to say is, like, you know, you see these movements and things like that, and those are nice, but, you know, they're soulless. It's like zombie-like. It's not,